Right. Yes. So we will be discussing about the Keel Microvision, right? Keel Microvision software for 8051 assembly language programming. So we can write the program in ALP, assembly language program, for 8051 microcontroller, and we can execute the program and we can check the result with the help of Keel software. Right, the software that we use is Keel, K-E-I-L, Keel Microvision. So here we will be using the version 5, right? Keel Microvision version 5 we are using. So I will be explaining the procedure that we use in the initial step before entering the code, right? Before texting the code, and after that we can execute the code. So before the operations, first let us see the procedure, right? Because I was using this particular video for the code now also, so you can access through the code now also whenever you forget the procedure, right? So whenever you type the KEIL, whenever you select the Keel software from your system, the Keel is already freely available in the net. You can use it, right? Otherwise, if you have any other licensed versions, then you can use it, Keel Microvision 5. Right, the Keel version 3 is there. You can use version 3, version 4, version 5, anything. So here I was selecting the Keel Microvision 5. This is a licensed version in our college. Right, so Keel Microvision 5 I was using. So first you go to the, after opening the software, right? First, go to the project, new Microvision project. First step is go to the project, new Microvision project. Just give the click and select the path, whatever the path that you want, right? In my system, G drive, MASM folder, in MASM folder, I was creating the project, right? So you can create your own project. The path depends on your interest, right? So here I was creating the project with PR2, right? And save the project. So here you need to select the device. This will ask the device, right, which device that you are going to use in this coding. So I am going to use the Atmel 89C51. Some way it will be, we can use the different versions. 89S52 is also there, right? Otherwise we can go for the some other things. I will show the so many devices. These are all various devices. For example, when you go to the Intel, right? So Intel 8051 AH version is there. Just see in an Intel 8051 AH version, LE22 right. So thank you. Here, 8051 AH is there, right? You just see. You can use the 8051. Otherwise, you can go for the 89C51 will be there. So in Intel, you will get the various models. So whatever the device that you want, you can select it. Most probably here we are going to use the Atmel, right? So you select the Atmel, Atmel 89C51. Here I am selecting the 89C51. You just see the features of this particular device here, right side. Right. 8051 based fully static 24 megahertz CMOS controller, right? So we can use the clock frequency up to the 24 megahertz, even more than that also we can go. With 32 I/O lines. How the 32 I/O lines means 4 ports it has. Right, and 2 timers are counters, you know very well, right? 2 timers, timer 0 and timer 1. six interrupts. Yes, you know even this also. Six interrupts it has. Six interrupts means reset and external interrupt zero. Reset external interrupt zero. Timer zero overflow interrupt and external interrupt one and serial interrupt. Right. Two external interrupts, two timer interrupts, 2 + 2 = 4, plus one serial interrupt 5, one reset, totally 6. Reset plus two external interrupts plus two timer interrupts 5 plus serial interrupt 6 interrupts. Right, memory it has UART. We have seen the UART operation in the 8051. And 4 KB ROM, right? 128 bytes RAM it has. These are the features he has given. Okay, I'm ready to accept use this particular device. You just give the OK. Start up project, add file. You can give the yes. Yes, right. So yes, the target is created, and you can do. You can start the coding. So anyway, you created the project, right, with a device 89C51 or 89S52 also you can take, right? So you created the project also. Now what you have to do is take the file new. So here you got the empty file, right? Now you can write the small assembly language programming. Can anyone tell the assembly language program for the edition of 8051? Anyone? Assembly language program for the edition of 8051. Just see, move A comma hash 22 H. I was using the code like this. Next, move B comma hash 11 H. Add A comma B. L call 0003H end. Simply, only 3-line program for the addition of 2 8-bit numbers in 8051. Just see how simple it is. You just save the code. So when you save the code, this will ask the your file name, right? So add1.asm. You need to give the extension .asm. This is very important. You need to give the extension .asm. That's very important. Same path, in the same path, right? Save, done, over. Now you get the colors. After saving the code, you will get the mnemonics and operands with the different colors. You can observe, right? If you are getting the colors, means then it is the controller is considered that particular line as the instruction, right? Now, so add one is the program. This one here, name appeared. I'm going to add this program to this target. I'm adding this add one file to the target 89C51, right? Add existing file to group source group one, right? Third option. Yeah, so here C source files file type is there. My file type is ASM file. So select the ASM always. ASM. Now your ASM add one appeared on the screen, right? Add one is your file. You just add it to the source group by clicking on the add. Next, close it. Now your ASM file is added here. This file, it is added to the source group now. Right. Now, this is the program. Now I am going to execute the program. Everyone observe this. Three steps only in execution mode, right? Only three steps. am observing the people who have raised inactive states, right? And also, right, okay. Yeah, now let us see the program, how we execute the program. First, do the translation, translate. Zero errors you got, you just see in the build out window, zero errors you got. Build and rebuild. Zero errors. For three steps, translate, zero errors, build, zero errors, rebuild also zero errors. For example, if I made any mistake, what happens? Let us observe. I was removing the comma here. In between B comma, 1, 1, I removed the comma. Now I will do the translate operation. Translate. One error is generated. Error ASM. Error A9. Just see here. Give the double click. Just to give the double click on this. Then immediately it goes to the particular line. Yes, it is saying some error here. You can observe comma is not there. Right. Now you can save the program. And now once again you do the translate operation. Zero errors now you got, right? Build and reboot. Similarly, if I make a mistake like if comma is not there in between A comma B, A and B, then what happens? Let us see this. Translate. You got the error, right? A9, line number 3. Select this and give the double click. So you can observe here and you can find the mistake and edit this, right? So this is the process that we can use it to find the errors in the program. So finally, anyway, zero errors, and now debug the program. This is a very important. Translate, build, rebuild after getting the zero errors. Leave about the warnings. After getting the three errors, after completing the three steps, then go to the debug. Debug, start, stop, debug session. You just give the okay. Yes. Now you are going to execute the program line by line. Just observe the program output line by line. Initially A value is 00, B value is 00. First, I am executing the line by pressing the F11 on the keyboard. F11 on the keyboard, or otherwise you can use this particular option. Right. Step on line. Step one line. Yes, A is loaded with the 22. Next. B is loaded with the 11. Next, add A comma B. 33. Result. Yes, you got the result. That is correct. This is only the result, A, B output. What you need to write in the left side of your recorder observation, just to keep these two and write down the result, right? A value and B value, that's all for this program, right? Because this program is available in theory and also lab. So that is why I was explaining now, and I'm going to put the same thing in the code now also. You can practice it at your home. If you forget any step, you can follow this. Right, I can execute all the instructions at a time also, right? Just I was doing the reset operation and just press the F5. All the lines at a time, this one, the left side, beside the reset run button will be there. So you can use the F5 on your keyboard also, right? So this is the procedure that we can use it to perform the addition, to perform the subtraction, to perform the multiplication, and also to perform the division, right? So you have the programs in your manual, whatever I provided, you can practice all the programs, right? Yes, if anybody is having any doubts, you can ask now. And one more thing is, now program is in debugging mode, right? So the program is in debugging mode. I want to stop the program. I want to come out from the debugging section, right? Stop. Now stop. After giving the same button, we will be using for start and also stop. That is why most of the people, what they do is, for example, if I debug the code by pressing the this button, particular Control F5 or start debug section. I am giving the start. Okay. Right. You just observe the how the screen it is appeared. It is under the debugging and also start section. So you can execute the program now. You don't edit the code now after came into the debug section, and whenever you start it, right? Once if you start it and you will get some yellow colors on the top of the ASM file, and right, whenever you get the debug section, then you don't edit the program here. Right? You need to stop the debug section always. That is better. Stop debug section. And you can do some editing in the code, right, if you want. So that is why start and stop two options will be there. In stop option, we can't get all the options, whatever it is available before the start. Right. Once if you went to the debug section, we can't get the all the editing options while debugging the code or while executing the code, right? So now the normal mode, then you can do the operations over the program. You can edit it, you can add some more lines, you can remove the lines, whatever you want. So even here, you can see the books. There are so many windows will be there. This is the project window, right? So here, when you see the view, here project window, sometimes project window may disappear. For example, when I close this, project window is not there here, but we always need the project window. So go to the view and project window. Now I will get the project window. Similarly, books, right? You can check the instruction manual, instruction set also available here. Instruction set manual, 8051 instructions also available here. When you use the key, this is only for your purpose, and in order to learn about the keel, I was giving all these details, right? Even instruction set also available, right? Takes some time to load. And anyway, you are going to use the project window, main one, right? Whenever you can, you are not getting the windows, project window is the main one, then go to the view always and check the windows, functions window. Right, and project window, all are available or not. Yes, anybody is having any doubts, you can ask now. Let me edit this code. 25B, 1, 2, add A comma B. Move 40H comma A. Save this. Translate. Build. Rebuild. As I was checking that memory content, zero errors, right? We can store the accumulator value even in the memory also, right? So I'm trying for that. Okay. So here we have to, here this is registers window, you just see. Sometimes we may close the registers window in the while doing the operation, because you just see while executing the program, some people, right, unknowingly they may close the window, right? If you close the window, then you can go to the view and you can take the your registers window from here, right? This is the registers window, right? For example, so if you close this, then go to the view and registers, you get it, right? Like that. So the people, what they think is, no, registers are not available, but sir told that after getting some yellow color or something, right, some ideas for remembering, right, I will get the registers A, B, S, P, but it is not appearing, like that they may think. And some people, they may close the registers window sometime, right, and they will try for the registers window, but it takes the less time to select the registers window or to go through the view always. So here, I'm trying for the memory. Yeah, memory window, right? So memory window. One, let me check for this. One minute. U memory windows. B colon 40. I'm executing the program line by line. Right. Yes, A is loaded. Next, B is loaded. And I was doing the addition. And now I'm copying this result 37 into the 40 memory location. 40. The first one is 40, right? Okay. I was executing this instruction to copy the A value into the B. Press F11. Yes, done. So this 37 is copied into the memory 40 of the SRAM, right? 8051 has the SRAM, some spaces meant for the data, and we can store this data in that memory, right? So this is regarding this. Let us write some more instructions like this. I will write the programs for subtraction, multiplication, division. You can use same programs for your 8051, right? For your lab also, right? You have this program in your lab. Debug. Stop. Now I was stopping the program, right? From the debug section. So registers window disappeared, memory window disappeared. I got the project window, books window, functions window, templates, these things, right? In stop mode. What I was doing now is move A,25H to this. Yes, I was taking this, subtract A comma B. SUBB, double B, A, comma, B. So A minus B, right? And we can store the result in move 41H. Now I am storing the subtraction result in the 41 memory location, right? Yeah. After that, once again, control V, A value. I was loading the A value, 25, same number I was using. If you want, you can use the different numbers. There is no wrong in that. And B value, same, it will be, right? Addition subtraction is over. Now I was doing the MUL, MUL, A, B. Malleab, there is no space between the A comma B for the multiplication. Next, move 41 is already over, 42 memory location, 42H comma A. Right, sometimes it, when we multiply two 8-bit numbers, sometimes we may get the 16-bit number. So the higher byte will be available in the B, in the multiplication. So move 43H comma B, register B value. Whenever we multiply, 16-bit number may appear, right? Now, yes, 43 is also over. Now, once again, move A comma B, move B comma 1 to these two instructions that we need for division. Control C and Control V. So, I was using this for addition. Arithmetic operations. And GICA, logical operations. Arithmetic and logical operations of 8051. If you want to put any comments, then you can use the forward slashes, two forward slashes, right? Addition. This is the addition program, right? After that, I think at the end of the yes, nine. Addition is over. Next. Subtraction. After that, multiplication. This is one experiment and also theory also. And we will be covering two things here. Multiplication and another one is division that we are going to do now. Right. After performing the div AB, it will be div AB. You can do div AB, there is no comma. Yes, we need to use these two instructions now. And control V. Because the coefficient is available in A and remainder is available in B in division operation. 44 and 45. These are the memory locations, right? Dear students, please remember this. These are the memory locations of the RAM. In that memory, we will be storing the result for various operations. Let us take addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Well, let us do AND operation. And right. Okay. We take these two numbers, control V, and after performing AND operation, we'll get the result in A. And memory location 46 is the Kali sequence memory location, right? Right. Yes, let us check the memory location sequence also. 40 for the addition, 41 for the subtraction, 42, 43 for the multiplication. Sometimes we may get the some higher value. 16-bit number and division 44 for the coefficient and also sequence 45 for the remainder from the B and AND operation. Yes, after performing the AND operation, A, N, L, AND logical. For AND operation, A, N, L, A, B. Right. Move a comma a sorry no 46 comma k right control c for operation control v for operation just see how simple it is coding move a comma 25x and move b comma this is the hexadecimal numbers url or logical or logical instruction url instruction right memory location 47 right now let us execute the program and let us check the result translate some mistake is there 30 I think anl a comma b let us see yes 38 url a comma b save the program translate zero errors now right build rebuild done next go to the debug start from debug session yeah okay memory window is already appeared if it is not appeared then you select it from the view right for example if it is not appeared then go to the view and memory window 1 right after that type here d this is very important my dear students type d colon 40 because you started the memory with the 40 memory location right 40 minimum you need to start the 40 only don't select 10 20 30 your own numbers you don't select because those are allocated for some special function registers and so many other things will be there in that memory locations so while selecting the 8051 ram address this is very important whatever the empty spaces were there we need to use the that particular empty spaces only after 3f from 40 onwards we can use it only right now let us execute the program line by line by pressing f11 on the keyboard f11 on the keyboard yes my first a value 25 is loaded next f11 b value 12 is loaded now I am performing the addition between two yes 40 resultant 37 yes it is loaded into the 40 memory location 40 next 41 subtraction result will appear yes press the f11 you just press here right next subtraction over and in 41 memory location you just observe the 41 memory location subtraction result will come now yes done next multiplication result execute it do the multiplication and copy the a value 90 is copied copy the b value into the 43 yes 02 is copied right the result is the multiplication of those two numbers is 0 to 90 right you should remember that next division operation and division result will appear here observe position cursor position and value change in the memory locations observe that 02 coefficient remainder 1 yes right like that logical operations and operation and logical and operation between these two and the result is 8 bit number 45 after that 46h is missed here that is why we did not got the result right just see For AND and OR, why we did not got the result, the here means H missed, right? 46H. This will treat as some decimal number and corresponding memory. This number will be copied, right? Anyway, let us you just observe this. You need to observe the result like this, right? So this is you can take the screenshot of this. Take the screenshot of this and copy the same thing in your observation or record.